Hi, my name is Megan, and I'm an alcoholic. I know it's kind of weird looking at me, like I'm not what people would usually associate with alcoholism. I'm not old and wrinkly and dirty and have taken all I can out of life. But what people don't realize is that alcoholism is a disease, just like diabetes, cancer. It doesn't necessarily have a cure, but it is treatable. And so, no, I don't go around committing felonies and just causing damage everywhere I go because I'm in treatment. And I'm hoping that a lot of people will get out of this talk that teenagers do suffer from alcoholism more than people know. 90% of addictions have roots in teen years. That means that 90% of all alcoholics, all addicts, developed the disease when they were teenagers. And only 10% of teenage alcoholics and addicts get the treatment that they need to recover. Alcoholism is an addiction to alcohol as well as the mental illnesses and disorders that come along with it. Like, for example, I struggle with depression and anxiety. Like, right now, I'm kind of freaking out talking in front of all you guys. But through recovery and through my journey through this entire crazy life that I've lived the past couple of years, I've learned that, like, I don't need to be ashamed of who I am. Like, I am an alcoholic. I do have depression. I do have anxiety. But that's not necessarily a bad thing. That doesn't make me a bad person. So I'll start off by telling my story. When I was in seventh grade, I experienced alcohol and marijuana for the first time. An older member of my family was very into it, and it was kind of always around me. And at that age, I didn't necessarily know who I was, but I wanted to. And I didn't really like myself that much. I thought that if I tried these things and became someone, anyone, it didn't really matter, then I would feel better about myself. I would have better self-esteem. I would think of myself as more of a whole person. So I experienced that a couple times, and then my family member got put into a rehab. And so the next year, my eighth grade year, I didn't really use drugs or alcohol, but my depression worsened because since my primary addiction was taken away, my body didn't know what to do with all the feelings. I didn't know how to cope. I hadn't developed healthy coping skills that I would have. So my depression worsened, my anxiety worsened, I struggled with self-harm. My image of myself was so negative. And so once freshman year came around, I decided that I was going to pick up drugs and alcohol again. And so when it first started, it was not a lot, just usually with friends. And then throughout the year, it progressed and progressed until I was at the point where my depression was just as bad as it was my eighth grade year. I was still using drugs and alcohol. I was branching off into harder drugs. I was just falling apart on the inside. And the worst part was, no one knew about it. I kept everything below the surface. I know it's kind of easy with my image and everything to make everything seem like it's okay. I was getting good grades. My parents didn't know about my addiction. And I was just kind of skating by, like just on the edge of a breakdown. And so the beginning of my sophomore year, everything was finally uncovered and I was put into rehab. And that's not necessarily the first place I wanted to go, but it was necessary. And at first, I didn't want to admit that I had a problem. I didn't want to admit that I was an alcoholic, because what teenager wants to admit that? I thought that I was just doing what teenagers were supposed to do. And so throughout my journey, I really learned a lot about myself and about alcoholism. Like, my disease has opened up so many opportunities for me. Like, I get to volunteer and work with the kids that I went to this rehab with, and I get to help new people that come in, and that just brightens up my week so much. I volunteer, I'm a dancer, I'm in choir. There's so much more to my life that I was kind of neglecting because drugs and alcohol were my primary focus. They were the most important thing in my life. Some of the myths about alcoholism are that if you just stop drinking, then the disease goes away, you're fine. That's all there is to it. But alcoholism isn't necessarily all about alcohol. It's a thinking disease. It's a mental disease. So when people stop drinking, other qualities come out. They may be more dishonest, steal, lie, other addictions that were hiding below the surface as well. And so to truly recover, they need to focus on the root of the problem. You can't recover completely, but there is treatment, and as long as you keep doing the treatment, then you manage everything. Like someone who has cancer takes chemotherapy to kind of keep it in check. And that's what I have to do to make sure that I maintain a healthy lifestyle. I'm hoping that you guys can spread the word about what addiction really is, because I know I was ashamed of who I was. I was ashamed that I was an alcoholic, ashamed that I was an addict. I thought people would look at me and not want to be around me because of the stigmas that go along with it. But I realize today that I am blessed to be an alcoholic because it has opened up so many options for me that I never knew were possible. It has made me into a person that I could have only dreamed of being. And I know without the help of my friends and family, none of it would have been possible. And there's actually a group of students at Barrington High School that struggles with the same things that I do. And every week during school, we meet and we just talk about recovery and addiction and where we are in our lives. And so it's slowly spreading that we don't have to be ashamed, we don't have to hide who we are, because there's nothing I can do to change who I am. I can't wake up one day and decide not to be an alcoholic. So I'm just extremely grateful for everything that I have now, and I could have never imagined standing up here and talking about this 2 years ago, but I'm really grateful that I had the opportunity to. And my name is Megan, and I'm an alcoholic.